So this is what's called second impact syndrome. Now, this is another study that was done in animals. And you can see here, this is a control group in this far left bar, if you can see my mouse moving. In the middle group, we have a group that had one concussion. And on the far right group, we have a group that had a severe traumatic brain injury. So you can see with concussion, you get about a 20% reduction in the ATP levels. And you can see with severe brain injury, you get about a 50% reduction in the ATP levels. Now, what these researchers wanted to do is they wanted to wait and give the animal a second concussion at different time points during the recovery to see what would happen. So remember we said that in a rat model, concussion injury recovers in about 5 days. So they waited full 5 days, gave the animal a secondary concussion, and you can see each one of these groups has a single star on it, which means that these two groups were not significantly different from one another. Okay? So meaning that if you get a full concussion and you recover fully and you get another one, it's just like having a second concussion. There's no additive or cumulative effect. You just go through the same process. Then they hit the animals at day three. So these are different groups, right? So this group had a concussion, this group had two, and they were only spaced out by 3 days. In this scenario, you have these two groups not being significantly different, meaning that if you get two concussions in close proximity before you've recovered from the first one, you can end up with a severe brain injury. And in fact, 10% of the animals in each of these groups died as a result of their injuries. 10% died in the severe brain injury group, and 10% died from getting two concussions back to back. This is what's known as second impact syndrome. This happens in young athletes. Probably once or twice every single year, there's a news story that comes out from somewhere in the world of somebody dying from second impact syndrome. Because they had a concussion and they returned to play too soon and got hit again. So this is the big thing as healthcare professionals, to make sure that we're not letting happen. The name of the game for concussion is recovery. And it's not just symptom recovery, it's from the metabolic recovery side of things, okay? And this is why. Human studies looking at the same thing. So there's a technology called magnetic resonance spectroscopy, or MRS. It's an MRI technology, but it looks at different metabolites within the brain. The one that we're interested in is called NAA, or N-acetyl aspartate. It is a correlate of ATP. So you can't measure ATP directly, but through this technology, which you can only get as a research tool right now, you can't just order these types of images. But when we look at these, you can see this NAA. So look at the black bars. So you can see this is a control group. This is their NAA levels. This is 3 days after injury. You can see there's a significant difference. This is 15 days after injury. You can see that there's still a significant difference from the control group. 22 days after injury, there's still a significant difference from the control group. And then it's not until day 30 that that single star disappears, indicating that there's no more significant difference from control. So what in the rat took 5 days for recovery, in the human takes somewhere between 22 and 30. We don't know if they were maybe fully recovered at day 23 or 24 or 25. We don't know. So somewhere between 3 and 4 weeks here, they hit that full recovery mark. Other studies have shown this up to 45 days after injury. But basically, somewhere between 3 and 6 weeks, it's gonna take a patient with a concussion to fully recover from that metabolic side of things. Here's the scary part. Every single patient in this study was asymptomatic by day 15. So symptoms do not reflect recovery of the brain when it comes to concussions. Unfortunately, a lot of our protocols still rely on symptom-based approaches, right? Oh, well, he no longer has symptoms, so then he can go. A lot of times, sports clubs will just require a doctor's note of any kind, and most physicians are simply relying on symptoms to guide their management decisions. And this is where you end up in trouble, right? Even at 2 weeks later, you would think that, hey, he's got no more symptoms, it's been 2 weeks, sure, go ahead and play. But there's still this period of time afterwards where the brain is potentially vulnerable to additional trauma.